despair! Your new master!
Kala raises the souls of the unspeakably evil.
You're sought to enslave all of Hyboria.
No man should live in chains.
Come on.
So there's this guy named Emperor Zim, and he wants to collect all the mystic pieces to an evil ancient curse mask so he can unleash an unspeakable evil across the land and become some sort of unholy doom god, or whatever. And it's up to Conan to stop him. Hell yeah. Basically, I had my bar set pretty low going into this movie. I only had two things on my checklist. Number one, hot naked fantasy babes, and number two, some kick-ass dude killing a lot of bad guys with a sword. And, yeah, check and double-check.
Crom, give me the strength to give an honest and fair review of the latest Conan the Barbarian movie. And if you do not listen, then to hell with you! Conan the Barbarian, oh yeah! Not gonna lie. I've been a pretty big fan of the whole Conan the Barbarian mythos since the Arnold movies. I even like that cheesy Saturday morning cartoon show they had back in the day.
Conan, the adventurer. Conan.
And I'm a really big fan of the books, so how does this movie stand up? I guess its worst crime is to say, it's okay. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not great. Which is really a shame, because there's a lot to work with this franchise. The movie is action-packed, almost to a fault. See, it seems almost terrified to slow down, catch its breath, meditate on the situation, develop characters. Instead, it's like, no, this generation's too busy tweeting and Facebooking and blogging and YouTubing and all that hipster energy drinking Four Locoing. We gotta get to the next action scene now! Now, get to the action scene! Ah! Really? I'm just like, whoa, movie. Listen, it's okay. I'm here for you. I'm here for you. Let's slow down, catch your breath, get to know each other. Certain side characters like the priestess or the thief or the pirate get into mortal peril. We don't really care, because we're like, oh no, not that guy. Yeah, I really care. Except I don't. In fact, the only one who really has any character development besides Conan, other than I'm a badass, is the evil villain invader or emperor Zim. No, that's his real name, Zim. He's got this whole complex of, I want to bring my dead wife back and become a god. Also, I got this whole incest thing with my daughter. It's kind of gross and creepy, but hey, it's something. Okay, I normally don't do this, but it's kind of a main drawback to why the movie isn't as good as it could be. Okay, so spoiler warning, yeah, this evil Emperor Zim guy, he wants the Doom Mask of Shadow Prophecy, whatever thingamabob. And because if he gets it, all hell's gonna break loose. Well, he gets it at the very end, and we're like, oh no, it's gonna hit the fan now. Oh, no way we're gonna survive this. This is worse than Adolf Hitler getting the Holy Grail, the Spear of Destiny, the Ark of the Covenant, and the Captain America Super Soldier Serum all in one. Oh no, what's he gonna do? And he doesn't do anything with the mask. He's like, aha, I got the mask. No one can defeat me now. What, are you gonna shoot lightning bolts? No. You gonna raise an army of zombies? Nope. Giant snake. You're gonna summon a giant snake? Nah. A flying monkey? Anything? What are you gonna do with it?
I'm going to make this cave crumble and fall down.
That's it?
That's it? Ooh, a cave in! Fail.
Yeah, I thought, you know, with that super evil mask. Ooh, the spooky mask. He was gonna, like, summon Cthulhu or raise evil flying zombie monkeys that juggle chainsaws or something. Or space elephants. But no, he doesn't do anything with it, like, at all. In fact, he was more of a badass and actually kicked the crap out of Conan before he even got the mask. So, if anything, this mask was a real downside to his whole evil plan. The mask sucks. My mask is way cooler. Doesn't even have any magic powers. Yeah, does it stack up against the Arnold movies? Well, admittedly, the Arnold movies are a little better, but maybe that's just my nostalgia talking. I guess it's just sort of filler, you know? Until Arnold Schwarzenegger gets back into shape and decides to film those old-school final chapters of Conan that everyone's been wishing for, and that I look up at the stars and pray that we one day get. So, I'm gonna have to give Conan a riddle. Not terrible, but not great, which is a shame, because really, it deserved to be. This is Razmere, so until next time, hope you enjoy the Conan movie. Later.